the London Array offshore wind farm. Turbines, row on row, silently generating power. And at the very centre, two identical offshore substations. Two hearts of the London Array offshore wind farm. From above, it all seems quiet, peaceful. But below the cold, glassy surface of the North Sea, the wind farm is alive. A hidden network of cables, running from these turbines to the two offshore substations, and from here back to the land. It's these cables, the vessels and arteries of the London Array offshore wind farm, that'll carry power back to the homes and businesses of the UK. It's mid-autumn 2012, and here, just a few miles out to sea in the Swale estuary, a very important process is taking place. This is the Stemat Spirit, a specialist cable installation vessel. And on board, the team are preparing to lay the last of four export cables, each more than 50 kilometres in length, which run from the two offshore substations back to the onshore substation here at Cleeve Hill in Kent. The export cables are the single heaviest item on the wind farm, each weighing in at around 4,500 tons. Manufactured in Norway, each of the export cables carries power back to shore through three copper cores, as well as housing vital fibre optic cores which allow remote communication and control of the offshore substations and the wind turbines. The four export cables were installed in continuous lengths of more than 50 kilometres by the team on board the Stemat Spirit, with the help of a specialist plough which lays and buries the export cable beneath the seabed. Years of meticulous planning has gone into the installation of the export cables, and it's a big day for everyone on board Stemat Spirit.
We've got four cables on this phase one of the project. And these cables help transmit the power from the substations that's being collected from the array field, then the power is being generated and sent through this power cable to Cleeve Hill. Challenges we have in this operation is the tidal flow, then we have the weather, and so we need good weather forecasts, and then we have the additional river users that have to be told what we're doing and informed all the time. It is quite a milestone for me here to see all four cables being finalised, really.
First, a buoyancy aid, called the Sea Serpent, is attached to the top of the cable to help keep it afloat until it reaches the onshore substation. The cable drum on the Stemat Spirit begins to turn slowly, and the first section of export cable is carefully pulled across the Swale estuary to a second installation barge, which acts as a midpoint between the Stemat Spirit and the shore. Installing the export cables is a 24-hour operation and is both weather and tide dependent, so finding a suitable window is often a huge challenge. However, the team doesn't let the cold or darkness stop operations. With temperatures well below zero, the first export cables are pulled under the sea wall and through a cable duct. From here, it's pulled through a trench up to the onshore substation at Cleeve Hill, where it'll eventually connect to the UK national grid. Back on board the Stemat Spirit, the team are preparing for the next stage in export cable installation. This specialist plough enables the team to lay and bury the cable below the seabed simultaneously as they move away from the shore.
This is the last of the export cables, HV4. We've just completed the float into Cleeve Hill, and we'll be shortly loading the product into the plough prior to putting it on the seabed. When the plough is on the seabed, obviously the ship will start moving ahead, the plough will start to dig in and to bury the cable at about 2 metres into the seabed. Once that's pulled into the substation and connected at Cleeve Hill, then that is the export cables for this phase completed.
As the plough disappears below the surface of the water, it marks a key point in the project. The Stemat Spirit team will now sail out to the offshore substation, laying and burying the cable as it goes, completing a key link between the London Array offshore wind farm and homes and businesses across the UK. A short distance from offshore substation 2, another key part of the cabling story is taking place. This is the Pontramaris, a cable installation barge. But here the team aren't installing export cable. This is one section of array cable. The array cables connect the turbines to the offshore substations, meaning that the power generated here can be transported quickly and safely to here. In total, the London Array is installing over 200 kilometres of array cable. 187 individual cables, ranging from 700 to 3,100 metres in length. The array cable was supplied by JDR, based in Littleport, England, and like the export cable, carries both power and fibre optic cables to remotely communicate with and control the turbines, ensuring that the London Array offshore wind farm is fully monitored and safe at all times. One challenge for the teams installing the array cables is the variety of different water levels on the London Array site. As a result, a number of different vessels have been used in order to install each length of cable safely and efficiently. Today, the team on board the Pontramaris barge have the task of installing just one length of cable between substation 2 and turbine G7. First, the team pull the cable up into the substation through J-tubes, which are located at the base of the substation. Here it's secured in place by the cabling tower team, who then give the go-ahead for Pontramaris to move away towards turbine G7. At this stage, the cable is carefully laid on the seabed, but the teams will return to bury it at a later date.
It's quite a complex process. Obviously, we've got lots of things against us, environmental for one. Essentially, we've got to make sure that the current is right for the vessel. We've got to make sure that the sea state is correct. Then we can start making the plans to put the cable over. We have teams that go on board the substation, will then clamp the cable, and the vessel will then surface lay the cable then off towards the relevant turbine.
Here at the opposite end of the process, the cable is pulled up through the transition piece J-tube and secured safely in place. It's this end of the cable that will eventually connect to the turbine generator and transport power from the wind back to the two offshore substations. The team works through the night in order to finish the installation. And here we see the final stages of the operation. Part of the cable is loaded into a quadrant, which ensures it's safely installed without being damaged. The quadrant is then lowered into the sea and rests on the seabed. Once in place, the team make any final checks and the Pontramaris moves away, off to install the next section of array cable. These sections of cables form part of a wider subsea network. Vital power links, running between turbines and two offshore substations. It's these vital links that will supply homes and businesses across the UK with clean, renewable energy, generated by the London Array offshore wind farm.